You are watching Skyrim commentary from Shauna Films.
Easy. Easy. Don't get up so quickly. How are you feeling? No. I saved your life. My arrow was tipped with a unique paralytic poison. It slowed your heart and kept you from bleeding out. Had I intended to kill you, we wouldn't be having this conversation.
Here they
my
come.
Original intention was to
my followers.
Use Mercer, but I never had a clear shot. I made a split-second decision to get you out of the way, and it prevented your death. More than you'll ever realize. The poison on the arrow took me a year to perfect. I only had enough for a single shot. All I had hoped was to capture Mercer alive. Mercer must be brought before the guild to answer for what he's done. He needs to pay for Gallus's murder. My purpose in using Snowvale Sanctum to ambush Mercer wasn't...
Anyway, this is one of the parts in Skyrim where...
Before both of you arrived,
a big chunk of the story is thrown in your lap.
The information we need is written inside.
You know, you're getting caught up to current events, sort of a thing.
I wish I knew.
I mean, there's a name. Oh, exposition. I guess that's what this is called.
I've never seen before. Enther, Gallus's friend at the College of Winterhold. Of course. The only outsider Gallus trusted with the knowledge.
So you recognize this scene right here? This is the scene with Serana, where she's asking you
myself,
where her mom might be hiding, and you mention the castle, a courtyard, and then she's like, oh yeah, the courtyard.
I'll tell you more about it later. Right now, you need to head for Winterhold with the journal.
That's another scene where you're being handed all this backstory.
It'll be useful for your journey.
So that you're caught up with events. I'm trying to think what other character in Skyrim does that. You meet them for the first time and they unload a whole bunch of lore.
Everyone respected him
and established fiction in your lap.
It was Gallus who inducted me into the Nightingales.
And you say one thing. You say one thing and it answers the question they've been hoping to find since the beginning of time, basically. They were clueless until they met you, and all of a sudden, their eyes are open. They see the light.
But think that I'm responsible for what happened to him.
Meanwhile, you got knocked out unconscious. That's about all you accomplished for them so far.
There are preparations to make, and Gallus's remains to lay to rest. I promise to join you there as soon as I can.
You know, here you get bonked out.
Trust no one else.
You get shot by Carlia, you're like knocked unconscious. The Serana story, you're banished from the castle. And you end up like, what was that all about, you know, kind of a thing. So who we got with this?
I can have a look at
them. Well, look what we have here.
And if that, I might be able to...
That's right, we're supposed to be killing some Silverhands. From like two or one videos ago. Because he's a glutton for punishment. Yeah, look at that Winterhold out there. It's all blurred out. Okay, what's going on here? Oh, it's the old dude.
I am waiting for a good death.
Should I even bother with this?
Yes. Were I to simply lay down and die, it would not please Malekith. Perhaps. Are you sure about this? We shall see.
Okay. Yeah, you got three wax news down for the count. I remember when he used to kill me constantly.
Dragonborn.
Back when I was like level 10-ish. I used to fear the old orc. Now it's like, I feel like,
strange how things turns out. You thought Kalia was the bad
guy. You know, the two guys in Westworld.
Was Mercer Fry.
The old movie, they wake up in the morning and Yul Brynner wants to kill them. And they're like, oh no, not you again. And they take turns deciding who's gonna kill Yul Brynner.
Shall we go and ask Enter about Gallon's Jana?
Yeah, I still have to watch my season one of Westworld just for the heck of it. I don't know if the show's any good, but it was cheap. It was cheap. Saw it at Walmart, so I bought it. I don't even know if I guess there was a season two, right? Of Westworld? I don't know. Or if it's ongoing, or if we're still, if people on HBO are still waiting. Oh, come on, you guys. Get your scripts and gear. Let's heal them up in case they got arthritis already. We're all supposed to be moving slow, I think, when there's a blizzard condition like this. I think. I'm not sure if the NPCs are affected. I know I am. I'm affected by the cold. I slow down if it starts to freeze. I don't remember if the NPCs do or not. I'm not using I Need. Or not I Need. What's the other, not I Need. What's the other one the guy wrote? Wet and Cold. I'm not using Wet and Cold to slow down people in blizzards. Because that would be too much. Too much overhead. I use I Need and Wet and Cold minimally. Because I have other mods that take care of things.
Keep walking. Well, look what we have here.
See, I didn't know this. I didn't know why he was so mad at me. But he was mad at me because I was no longer a member of the Companions, which I didn't know happened. I didn't know I got kicked out of the Companions during a companion quest. Anyway, I had to fast forward through that part because all the dudes out in the front yard of this place were naked. And YouTube hates to see naked dudes, so I chopped out that stuff. They were naked because I've ripped out OBIS in the middle of this playthrough. OBIS made all the dudes outside naked. They were spawned like eons ago. Yeah, OBIS spawns everyone outdoors, even if you don't visit those locations, they're spawned. I guess that's the first thing it does when the game starts. Or when the mod starts. It populates the outdoors with all the bandits. And then when you rip out OBIS, the game doesn't know what to do because you've ripped out the armored sets, you've ripped out the generated heads, and you ripped out their inspirations. So you end up with these naked T-pose dudes that are headless. And, I'm using better males for my dude replacer, so...
Sure.
That's an extra no-no for YouTube.
Yes, what is it?
We're all gonna dress up like werewolves. It'll be fun. I should have given one to my companion back there, just to piss him off. Come back to Yorvaskr, dressed up as a werewolf. You'll have stories to tell. Oh yeah, at some point I gave Vilya all the jewelry.
Yes, what is it?
Because I couldn't carry it all.
Sure.
I gave Brigmore all the ingredients. Because I couldn't carry anymore. I mean, guess how many stupid blue flowers I had. I think I had like over 200. And each one was point one or point two weight.
Sure.
So that adds up after a while when you have 200 of them in your inventory. I had like 50 lavenders. I don't know why. I wasn't even using the lavenders. I'm just pulling them out of the ground. Everywhere I go, I'm just pulling them out of the ground. And the snowberries.
Yes,
oh man.
What is it?
I had wads of snowberries. Every time I saw one out on the roadside, I'd snatch one. So that adds to your carry weight limit. After a while, and you're wondering why you can't even pick up a knife without upsetting the balance of things. So all of us have water things. All of us have food. So we're all going to be drinking and chewing food in here at the best opportunities, or the least opportune moments. Thought I heard something. What was that? Oh, I'm filthy. I need a bath. So I'm not gonna be able to sneak up on anything if I smell like raw sewage. So last night I was trying out some new mods, or not new mods, just new to me, and I thought they were breaking my game, so I took them out, and then I find out my game was broken before I installed them. So I had to uninstall them again, fix the problem in my game, put the mods back in. So that's where I'm at now. So one of the mods is called Time Passes, which I never knew existed. It's about 2 years old now, but to me it's a brand new mod. Kind of clever how it works. And I ripped out the Great City of Rorikstead, because I need an ESP. I'm running out of ESPs now. Or ESP slots, I mean.
Sure.
And I don't really need a Great City of Rorikstead in my game. The old Rorikstead is just fine. I'm trying to think what the other mods were that I was messing with. Oh, I can't remember now. See, I couldn't even sneak up on this person.
You heard?
There's someone there?
Yeah! Just chop him in half.
It's a shame
thing that was necessary.
Now the bandits inside the caves and dungeons, they're fine. Because they were never spawned until I actually showed up in here. It's just outside is when I have issues. I mean, OBIS is a great mod if you're playing your Skyrim back in, you know, 2015. But since, you know, Skyrim and mods and things have been updated since then, OBIS has not been updated. So it's, you know, it's showing its age. And I noticed on Nexus, the latest rage still is to backport mods from Special Edition. Or as some people say, Second Edition. Skyrim Second Edition. So that's kind of clever, you know, people take the SSE and shove it into the LE, and it works with some effort. So now, old rim gamers, as some people say, they get the glory. And here's the best part. The mods look better in limited edition than they do in second edition. AKA legendary edition. So, who's in here?
Footsteps.
Just this person? Oh man. He was just getting up to tie his shoes. It's a sword right to the earlobe. Yeah, the Spoils of War, that's what Legendary Edition's been getting lately. All the Spoils of War, the successful mods that are in Special Edition trickle up, or is it down? They trickle down to Legendary Edition now, because of technologies. But Driscoll, as people would say, Special Edition is 64-bit. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, 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 blah. Like, so I go and I watch their Special Edition videos. And their game crashes exactly where my game crashes. And it's not because... It's just because poor scripting in the game is all. 64-bit will not fix bad writing. There's just more room for more bad writing is all. Like with Marvel's Endgame, you can chop out an hour and a half of that movie and not miss anything.
Yeah.
I cannot miss.
That's good. Look at that bow.
But the reason why Endgame is 3 hours long is because half of the movie is just fan service. And one of the first movies I saw in the theater that was fan service was Herbie the Love Bug Rides Again. Now actually it would have been fan service thing would be like Beneath the Planet of the Apes or Star Trek the Motion Picture had fan service in it. You can chop those scenes out and you end up with a tighter film with a better story. And then, of course, you know, the later Star Trek movies had fan service. You know, the J.J. Abrams Star Treks. The weird part is, people that watch these Avengers movies, they go to the comic book stores and look for the comic books, and they're defranchised. Or disenfranchised, is that the word? Because when they see what the comic books are currently doing with their favorite characters, it's very...
What?
It's a traumatic experience. Now, people like me have collections, years worth of collections of, you know, comic books from the 70s and 80s. So, like, we've read all the best comics there ever were, that there ever will be. And millennials, they won't be able to, unless they, I guess you just subscribe to a service and you can get old issues, you know, as PDFs or something. Read them on your phone or something. I don't know if that's a good experience, but that might be the only way to read comic books that are worth anything these days. Because the comic books coming out now are just, they're just utter crap. Crap for like the last 5 years, they've been crap. Yeah, I was looking at an X-Men issue the other day that I have. Stuff that was being done in that issue, they cannot get away with writing that comic book these days. So much political incorrectness in those comic books. Then today everyone's going ballistic about Game of Thrones, their series finale. Everyone's all upset. Well, not everyone, but the whack jobs out there are all upset that a guy won the prize at the end, supposedly. There's like none of the women got anything after 8 years of seasons. Some binary cisgender or whatever. You know, some white dude got the part. So. Then, if you watch the new Toy Story 4 trailer, you see that there's this little Bo Peep, whatever her name is, the toy, the girl toy. She's empowered. She's the superwoman. Woody and Buzz, they're beta males. It's just different. I don't know if it's going to be an entertaining story for most folks, or if it's just going to be a money grab. Anyway, so back to Skyrim. Basically, I got more werewolves installed, so that's why there's werewolves in cages, and they don't attack me unless I open their cage.
Oops. You're good as dead.
That's that. Shall we continue?
By Talos, you here alive.
They ran right past that person.
don't know when it's time to give up.
Anyway, so there's this... This happened in the last two playthroughs, where the werewolf is not in his cage. And the werewolf is killing people. And runs back to its cage. For some reason, it's spawning outside of its cage. But it won't attack me. It only attacks my enemies. In other words, the werewolf is my ally. You'll see right here when I come into this one area where the cage is. And I didn't know what was going on in my last couple of playthroughs. See, the werewolf walks back to his cage, but he can't get in because the door's locked. He's totally ignoring me. But he'll murder any bad guys that come by. So I thought this was interesting. So he's supposed to be in. But as soon as I open this door and step in here, you know, I'm the bad guy, all of a sudden. Come on, you guys, get out of the way.
Oh, sorry.
And if I open this one, he'll attack. But I think... Someone has to walk by the door for this to happen.
I wish you wouldn't take so many risks. Sometimes it scares me.
I'm still used to being a vampire where one swat from a wolf would kill me. But I have to get used to not being a werewolf or a vampire anymore. My armor actually works now, so I don't have to run away.
Thought I heard something.
Ooh.
I'll smash your head.
Yeah. That was kind of close. That was annoying as hell. Can I move or I'm stuck? No, I can move.
How are you doing? You don't look well at all.
Sure. Anything in particular? Yes? Do you want me to heal you? Sure. But then you better keep the enemies away from me. Or am I supposed to keep us both healed and kill the enemies as well?
I'm totally covered in filth. Yeah, I was used to Mickey healing me all the time, but she's not with us. I thought she was. She was with us in the last video, right? Oh no, she's with us later on in this video. Maybe in the next video, Mickey shows up. She wouldn't heal me when I was a vampire. Because she won't heal vampires. She only heals living people. So once I became a living person again, I had Mickey with us. Anyway, for some reason, she's not with us. So Vilya can do the thing. Anyway, so I went back. I wanted to see this scene again.
Don't you think so?
Somebody help!
On you!
Let it go!
Hit it! Come on, you guys, get out of the way!
Uh oh!
Come on!
Yeah. We make quite the team, eh?
Yeah, it's hard to shoot. I can't. My NPCs love to stand between me and the bad guy when I'm holding arrows. Okay, so this guy is gonna go back up there. I had this great idea that I would move him into the cage clipping. I tried to move him. That didn't work. Usually when you move something, it moves them behind you, so if I stood up against the cage, maybe it would be in the cage when it moved behind me, but no. So I thought, oh, turn clipping off, turn it back on. Will that work? Okay, so now it's in the cage with me. What am I doing now? I'm trying to get myself killed.
Yes?
Okay. So now it's in the cage, and is that Villia in the cage? I was too lazy, so I think I just opened the door. Oh, did I zap her out of there? Oh, I did. See, this is how it's supposed to be when you come here. If you have more werewolves installed. You got werebears too and stuff. I think it's random what gets spawned in these areas. And then the minute I open the door...
Strange.
So it is working, sort of, kind of. It's just...
What was that? You missed my sword! You okay?
I want to say the companion is getting the most damage done.
By Talos, you won't leave here alive.
You hurt?
I wish I could shoot my arrows without someone standing in front of me. That would be nice. Maybe there's a mod out there that makes NPCs better at not standing in front of your arrows. I'm sure there is, but it would involve reloading Skyrim mods from scratch to get things to work right again. Which I don't feel like going through again for a long while. Where are you? Hard to see with the fog, or smog, or whatever that is. The stink that's in this room. You can see the stink. So what happens now with all those people that got tattoos of the blonde chick who rode dragons on Game of Thrones? What's her name? Daenerys or something? All those people that have her tattooed on their body somewhere, what are they thinking right now? What were they thinking? See, that's why tattoos are not a good idea. In the town I live in, I think I'm the only person left that doesn't have tattoos. There's this one girl I like recently, and I had some weird idea that I was gonna say, hey, let's hang out, let's go do something, you know, something like that. And then recently, you know, I was gonna say, hey, let's go do something, and she's got tattoos all over her body. It's like, oh, I'm like,
it's time for you to leave, my friend.
I did one of those mind wipe right there on the spot. Did a mind wipe, so I just erased her from my memory. Yeah, I don't date women who have tattoos. It's not a thing. They're getting harder and harder to find. First thing women want to do is start marking their bodies up permanently. Ay, ay, ay. Yeah, I blame Pamela Anderson for starting that whole nonsense. It was bad enough when you had Tammy Faye Baker putting makeup on her face. But then you had Pamela Anderson getting, you know, just hideous tattoos just because her husband had tattoos. It's like, whatever. I mean, what are you gonna do with these tattoos when you're like 60, 70 years old? You're gonna look like a retarded mongrel, feral, old crazy woman. Not a wise shaman type medicine witch hunter lady who shrinks heads, but no, you're gonna look like the crazy mad woman who has no teeth and mumbles to herself. Plays with children's skulls and things. That's what happens. If you play enough Skyrim, that's the kind of people you run into in real life. Bucket! Knife! Bucket! Who's that person in the Ratway Warrens? Yeah, those are the kind of people that you have now living in your cities. They live in every sewer, every alley. They live under the freeway, under the bridge, where the river goes under. That's where they bathe and do their thing. Their big deal is car batteries. You know, they steal car batteries so they can charge up their iPhones, so they can have internet. Internet while they're in the sewer pipes. I shot her in the wrist and she goes flying. The weird part is, how do these bums recharge their car batteries? The answer is they don't. They try to return the battery the minute it's dead, and they try to buy a new battery that's charged. That's their goal in life. This is what they do. Thieves and bums, they go into a store, they buy a brand new phone because they're assuming it's going to be charged. And then they use the phone up until it loses its charge, and then they want to return the phone. You exchange it for another one because the other one's charged. That's what they do. Basically, they're using their phones for drug deals.
This is not what I thought we would be doing.
Human trafficking. Stealing other people's IDs. Trying to get into their bank accounts, their debits. All that kind of stuff. Well, this video turned into a rant. But what else am I going to talk about in this place? I'm killing the Silverhands. Next Next case. We have to return this thing we took back to a Cardlac. Or not Cardlac, but to just return it to Yorvaskar, I guess.
Come up to the Sky Forge to pay your respects.
Yeah, because Cardlac's dead. He has no need for this piece of drama. I had to chop out another part of this scene because, another part of this video had naked Cardlac, and I don't want that to be a thing. Oh, there's a. I couldn't find them, all the things that were out here trying to kill us. Oh, it's raining. Oh, that's a sad. Sad thing. Cardlac's funeral pyre thing. It's gonna get rained on. So who we got now? We got Rigmor. We got Velia. And I'm starting to freeze to death out here. Why?
I have read up so much on the bard chance now that I think I should be able to use
it. Oh, probably. Oh, I'm wet. I'm soaking wet. That's probably why I'm freezing to death.
I think that I should now be able to use my bard chance in fights. But don't expect any miracles. I'm not that good. Yet.
Yet.
But whenever we have time to go through my fighting instructions, we should decide which chants you would want me to try out.
Chants? Okay. We'll decide what chants
to use. Wouldn't it be nice to talk a little, you and I? I feel so sad when I see the body of an adventurer, all dead and curled up. I wonder, is anyone waiting for them at home?
Yeah, so Cardlac was naked up here because of better males?
Before the ancient flame.
We grieve.
We grieve.
At this loss, we weep. For the fallen,
we shout.
And for ourselves.
At least there was some fire up here to warm me up.
Take our leave.
So I don't totally pass out and die. Everyone else seems to be okay. It's just me that's freezing to death. Everyone's busy.
Don't you think so?
His spirit is departed. Members of the Circle, let us withdraw to the Underforge to grieve our last together.
Oh, the blacksmith. He's trying to pathfind his way to me. Too many people up here.
Do you have the fragments of Wuthrad still?
I'll need to prepare them for mounting again. Don't get too flowery on me, lad. Of course, I have a small favor to ask of you. There's another piece that Cardlac always kept close to himself. Would you go to his chambers and bring it back for me? I'm not sure I'm the best one to go through his things. Thank you. I'll be here.
So what else happened the other day?
Did you know that Michael, the bard of the Band of Mad,
I remember.
Was the author of a
gentleman I went on. I do this like once a week.
What do you want?
I go into a RPG forum and mention the word roleplay, and of course everyone wants to ban me from the forum for mentioning roleplay. So that's still a thing. I don't know if that issue is ever going to go away. Anyway, so let's get back to the Skyrim, shall we? Everyone still hates me. I wasn't sure what to do here.
You need to leave.
Should have known.
What did I tell you? Ysgrimor himself wouldn't have the patience to deal with your insolence.
So she was asking me for money.
Know your place and pay your debts and we'll forget. Gold, silver, gems maybe. You will pay the price.
It was 16,000 gold.
You know what to do.
16,000.
Very good. Let's see what you have here. Very well then. I accept your apology.
It doubles?
I'll go tell the others.
I guess the next time it's going to be 32,000?
There's nothing more I can teach you. Mm-hmm.
Anyway, so now I'm...
Let me still... Alone.
Not now.
So now they're acting normal.
Leave me.
So once again, I'm one of the companions now.
Leave me.
It's a good thing I'm super rich. So I had to check on the sassy teens, because they all hated me as well, because they're part of the werewolf faction. Or, companion faction.
Hi there.
So she's talking to me for once.
Fine. Keep your hands to yourself.
Wow. Okay.
Yes?
Sure. Anything in particular you have in mind? Yes, you do want me to use my spells, right? Oh, I would. Let me see if you have got something that I... If you say so.
I heard about what happened.
Sure. Anything in particular you have in mind? Yes? Do you want me to heal you? If you say so.
Anytime.
I heard dialogue.
You
it's
know,
so
the
confusing.
Best defense isn't a good armor. It's a good, strong... Sure. Anything in particular you have in mind?
Oh, I'd be happy to use a chant during combat. But choose wisely, because I can only use one at a time.
They're all pretty...
Absurd that you
they have... Each of her chants has an advantage and a disadvantage to use it. Yeah, so choose wisely. I think at this point, I probably didn't choose one. She's already overpowered.
Sure.
Yeah. So,
what are we going now?
I was looking for...
What makes this smell?
I can't sleep in any of these beds. I have to like go in the basement if I want to sleep. I don't know who owns these two beds here.
I've been tending to the warriors of Yorvaskar for as long as I can remember. Goodbye, dear.
I'm just looking at her. Her neck seam looks okay.